think it's taken this long for new ramps to kind of come around for quite a few different reasons. One, I think it's taken up until now for our ability to kind of reach the potential of our old ramps. The old ramps have maybe been part of the reason the sport's kind of staled off a little bit over the last couple of years, because we haven't seen a lot of new tricks come from 75-foot ramps or super kickers. A lot of the tricks have been coming from quarter pipes. It's been kind of a long time coming. I've had the idea the last couple of years, and I don't really know how many versions of these ramps I've actually drawn out, but I've finally come to a point where I'm happy with the plans and gonna test them out. The main goal of these ramps weren't for self-benefit at all. Obviously, I love jumping steeper stuff and getting a little bit more float in the air, but the idea of building these ramps is to get them out to everybody, not just to turn up to a competition and just blindside people with a new ramp that only I've been riding. Yeah, I'm self-taught with pretty much everything I've done. I actually left school to be an engineer, but before I made it to my apprenticeship, I started riding dirt bikes full-time, so I never went back to that. But since I had the opportunity to build this shed and fit out a workshop, I've kind of pretty much just lived down here in the shed for the last few years and learnt how to weld, machine, a bit of everything really, so it's all kind of coming into play now. I want to build these ramps. What I'm doing now is kind of combining two passions or hobbies or whatever you want to call it. Like, I'd always ride my bike and then I'd build stuff which would be completely irrelevant to riding or dirt bikes, and then I kind of clicked, like, if I combine the two, it makes a lot more fun for me and I can actually progress a lot further than I thought I would. For years and years I was always wanting more hang time, and I thought I needed to go bigger and bigger, you know, keep pushing the ramp back, push it back. But one thing that kind of clicked this year for me was actually pushing the ramp a little bit forward and jacking it up. We keep the torque in our bike, and with the acceleration of the bike is where the spin comes from and the pop. Everyone needs to step out of their comfort zone probably a little bit when they jump these ramps, but that's just natural with anything new that we do. You can build them and jump them to dirt straight away. I'd highly recommend pushing them in closer and then bringing them back out, because the speeds are slightly different to jumping our regular ramps. You don't need to go ride an airbag or a foam pit to flip them for the first time. The motivation to take the sport in a different direction is just to enhance it a little bit, to make it a little bit better, to give it that little bit more of an edge, kind of some fresh life.